30. Most of the Sun-like stars in our galaxy are in multiple star systems. Our Sun may be a single star, but it is in the minority. More than half of the Sun-like stars in the Milky Way are part of binary or ternary multiple star systems orbiting a common center of mass. But most lower-mass stars, such as red dwarfs, live alone without a companion star. 29. Large amounts of water have been found in space. Earth's oceans may not be so unique after all. Three moons of Jupiter, Europa, Ganymede, and Callisto, and two moons of Saturn, Enceladus and Titan, are thought to have underwater seas. Europa's ocean may contain more than twice the water found on Earth. However, the most water discovered so far is around a black hole about 12 billion light years away. This region contains an amount of water vapor equivalent to 140 trillion times the volume of water in the Earth's oceans. 28. There is gravity on the International Space Station. Although images of astronauts on the International Space Station give the impression of a zero-gravity environment, gravity on the station is actually only 10 to 11% weaker than on the Earth's surface. One of these facts is related to the widespread belief that there is no gravity in space. Because the space station is in constant free fall, astronauts float freely. This is the same effect that paratroopers experience. Its difference from the ISS is that it also moves horizontally. As the International Space Station moves sideways and descends towards Earth, the horizon recedes beneath it at the same rate, keeping the ISS in orbit and creating a feeling of weightlessness for everyone on board. 27. 5 billion suns can fit in UY Scuti, one of the largest known stars. Compared to the other worlds in our solar system, even the massive Jupiter, our Sun is quite large, but it can't even be compared to the biggest stars we know. UY Scuti is often referred to as the largest known star in the universe. Calculations revealed that if UY Scuti were to replace the Sun, its outer edge would be beyond the orbit of Jupiter. 5 billion suns, 7 trillion Jupiters, or 7 quadrillion Earths could fit inside UY Scuti. Moreover, UY Scuti is 300,000 times brighter than the Sun, but it is so far away that you cannot notice it when you observe it in the night sky. 26. There may be up to 10 billion Earth-like planets in the Milky Way. In 2019, astronomers combined data from the Kepler Space Telescope with new results from the European Space Agency's Gaia mission to conclude that, on average, 1 in 6 stars hosts an Earth-sized planet in its habitable zone. There are potentially tens of billions of such worlds scattered across the Milky Way. As the search for Earth-like planets continues, the range of environments that can be considered habitable is expanding. A complete Earth analog may not be necessary for complex life, and the number of life-supporting refugees may be greater than we think. 25. Shooting stars take on various colors, depending on the elements from which they are formed. When you see a bright meteor, look carefully, and you may notice vibrant colors. Sometimes, you may even see several different colors as the meteor moves forward. The brightest, most dazzling meteors, known as fireballs, are more likely to show you these colors because they burn longer. Colors are associated with different elements and form compounds trapped in ice or rock. Compounds rise well beyond their combustion temperatures, and elements emit different colors of light. Magnesium glows blue-white or cyan. Calcium appears purple, sodium orange. Iron shines yellow-white. Nitrogen and oxygen produce distinctive reds. 24. There are countless stars in the known universe. We fundamentally don't know how many stars there are in the universe. We are currently estimating how many stars there are in our own galaxy, the Milky Way. We then multiply this number by our best estimate of the number of galaxies in the universe. After all this math, NASA can only say with confidence that there are uncountable zillions of stars. A zillion is any uncountable quantity. An Australian National University study put their estimate at 70 sextillion. In other words, that's 70,000 million million million. 23. Apollo astronauts' footprints on the moon will likely remain there for at least 100 million years. Since the moon does not have an atmosphere, there is no wind or water to erode or wash away the trail that Apollo astronauts left on the moon. This means that footprints, rover tracks, spaceship tracks, and discarded materials will be preserved on the moon for a very long time, but they won't stay there forever. The moon is still a dynamic environment. In fact, it is constantly bombarded with micrometeorites, which means that erosion on the moon is still happening, just very slowly. 22. If two pieces of metal of the same type touch each other in space, they stick together and become permanently attached. This amazing effect is called cold welding. This is because the atoms of the individual pieces of metal have no way of knowing that they are different pieces of metal, so the lumps come together. This wouldn't happen on Earth because there is air and water separating the pieces. This effect has numerous implications for spacecraft construction and the future of metal-based construction in vacuums. 21. The largest asteroid in our solar system is a giant space rock called Ceres. The asteroid, sometimes known as a dwarf planet, is approximately 600 miles in diameter. It is the largest asteroid in the asteroid belt between Mars and Jupiter, accounting for one-third of the mass of the belt. Ceres's surface area is approximately equal to the land area of India or Argentina. 20. Venus rotates in the opposite direction to most planets in our solar system. While most planets, including Earth, rotate counterclockwise when viewed from the North Poles, Venus rotates clockwise. This means that if you could stand on the surface of Venus, the sun would rise in the west and set in the east. The reason behind Venus' retrograde rotation remains the subject of scientific research. One hypothesis suggests that Venus may have experienced a large collision or gravitational interaction early in its history that reversed its rotation. Another theory suggests that Venus's dense atmosphere and interactions with strong atmospheric currents may have affected rotation dynamics over time. Despite its slow rotation, taking about 243 Earth days to complete a day-night cycle, Venus's atmosphere rotates much faster around the planet, with winds reaching speeds of 360 kilometers per hour. 19. The position of the North Star will change over time. Navigation will be awkward when Polaris ceases to be the North Star in about 13,000 years. If you don't know, the Earth's axis goes through a movement called precession, which means the planet's axis will change and follow a cone shape. When this happens, it takes about 26,000 years for the axis to form a complete cone shape. In addition, Polaris, Earth's current North Star, will eventually begin to shift position as Earth undergoes precession. In 3000 BC, the North Star is believed to be the star Thuban, also known as Alpha Draconis. In about 13,000 years, the star Vega will become the new North Star. But after 26,000 years, Polaris will return to its original position as the Earth continues to move forward. 18. Enceladus, one of Saturn's small moons, reflects 90% of the light coming from the Sun. Because Enceladus's icy surface reflects sunlight rather than absorbing it, temperatures can drop as low as -201 degrees Celsius. 17. Neptune's moon Triton orbits the planet in the opposite direction. Triton is the only large moon of the planets with this feature. This is called a retrograde orbit, and astronomers aren't sure why Triton orbits Neptune this way. 16. Triton is getting closer to the planet it orbits. Scientists believe that when Triton eventually gets too close to Neptune, it will be torn apart by the planet's gravity and could potentially form another ring around Neptune, thus having more rings than Saturn. 15. You can see 3 to 7 different galaxies from Earth with the naked eye. You can see the Andromeda Galaxy, both Magellanic Clouds, the Milky Way Galaxy, the Triangle Galaxy, Omega Centauri, and the Sagittarius Dwarf Spherical Galaxy. 14. Metal snow and sulfuric acid rain occur on Venus. This is because Venus is a scorching planet, choked with sulfuric acid. This acid causes the planet's metals to turn into gases, and then liquids in the atmosphere, turning into solids at freezing temperatures, and then falling to the ground as rain. 13. Sunset on Mars is blue. Mars has less than 1% of Earth's atmosphere, so sunsets on Mars appear blue because of the way blue light from the sun is captured in the Martian atmosphere. 12. A large percentage of asteroids are pulled by Jupiter's gravitational pull. For this reason, Jupiter is known as the garbage dump of our solar system. Most asteroids that are potentially harmful to Earth, namely long-period comets, tend to be attracted to Jupiter's gravitational field. 11. All the planets in our solar system can fit in about 4,300 kilometers of space between the Earth and the Moon. 10. About 2 billion years ago, Venus looked very similar to how Earth looks now. Venus today is a living hell. There is a stifling atmosphere of carbon dioxide and almost no water vapor. Temperatures there reach 462 degrees Celsius, but climate modeling has suggested that ancient Venus may have had oceans and a dry land pattern just like ours. Several factors, such as the water-to-land ratio and the idea that clouds potentially shielded Venus from strong sunlight, suggest that the planet may have once been habitable. 9. Dark matter is believed to be responsible for 85% of the gravity in the universe, and no one knows what it is or how it works. According to Neil deGrasse Tyson, dark matter is the longest unsolved mystery in modern astrophysics. It may not even be matter. Essentially, the amount of gravity in the universe is not exactly equal to the amount of observable mass. Planets, stars, galaxies, comets, black holes, and dark clouds. So scientists suggest that there is a large amount of unobservable or dark mass in the universe, and that this is the source of all this gravity. 8. The moon probably came from Earth. Scientists believe that the early Earth was hit by another object 4.5 billion years ago, and received a piece that eventually formed what we know as the Moon. Research has confirmed that the Moon is made of the same material as the crust of the early Earth, indicating that an explosive event, known as the Giant Impact Hypothesis, may have led to its formation. 7. There is an interesting reason why space looks black. You might think that there should be no black areas, considering that stars should be everywhere and fill the sky with light. This phenomenon is known as the Olbers paradox, named after the German astronomer Heinrich Wilhelm Olbers in 1823. If the universe is infinite, static, and timeless, then everywhere you look must eventually hit a star. It turns out that the universe is neither static nor timeless. Edwin Hubble discovered that the universe is expanding, and thermal radiation from the Big Bang indicates that the universe is 13.8 billion years old. We cannot see stars in all directions because some stars do not exist long enough for their light to reach us. 6. You can probably generate electricity from space. Tesla theorized that if you inserted a rod deep enough into space, the temperature difference between the vacuum of space and the Earth would create an electric current that could start a motor. It's definitely possible, but probably not worth the hassle just to get one engine started. 5. There is water on Mars. There is evidence to suggest that liquid water once flowed on Mars and may still be found in underground reservoirs. 4. Fermi paradox. In a casual lunch conversation in 1950, "Where is everyone?" it bears the name of physicist Enrico Fermi, who asked, "Although there are many stars and potentially habitable planets, we have no evidence of extraterrestrial civilizations." According to theory, communication with aliens is almost impossible, because an intelligent civilization may have destroyed each other, been destroyed by an asteroid, or may be hiding from us and other aliens. 3. Astronauts age slightly slower. Due to the effects of time dilation, astronauts on the International Space Station age slightly more slowly than people on Earth. 2. Spacecraft speed record. The Parker Solar Probe, launched by NASA in 2018, is the fastest human-made object, traveling at speeds of up to 700,000 kilometers per hour. 1. Pluto's orbit. Pluto's orbit is highly eccentric, causing it to sometimes come closer to the Sun than Neptune. Pluto's orbit is quite unique in our solar system. It is highly elliptical, meaning that its distance from the Sun varies significantly during its orbit. Sometimes Pluto is closer to the Sun than Neptune, which is one of the reasons why Pluto was considered the ninth planet before it was reclassified. This eccentric orbit also contributes to Pluto having a different orbital inclination compared to the larger planets in our solar system. We have come to the end of the video with 30 amazing facts about space. Don't forget to like and follow the channel so you don't miss any Science Buster videos. Thanks for watching. Bye.